Hello, Tim Gavel here from the Region Media Group for the Sports Report for the week. We're down here at Brumbies headquarters, of course, with the Brumbies Super W side in action on the weekend. They defeated the Melbourne Rebels 30-5. They now head to Coffs Harbour for two games, Sunday and then Wednesday. Wednesday, they play New South Wales. Sunday's game is against the President's 15. Alongside me is the Brumbies Super W side's assistant coach, Lachlan Creighton. And Lachie, really good start, 30-5 against the Rebels. I guess it's going to be a little bit harder, you'd think, against the Waratahs next Wednesday.
Yeah, I think so. Look, they're going well. They're undefeated. They have been for the last 3 years. So it's certainly a challenge for us, but something we're not afraid of.
Just on the weekend's performance, what pleased you most about that?
Oh, look, the word resilience comes up quite often. We defended for over 23 minutes on our line and we didn't concede a point, so that's really pleasing. There's certainly a few areas in our attack that we need to improve. Just comes back to just knowing your role and your detail and urgency to set.
Yeah, just tell us about some of the team. Of course, you've got Jane Garraway there at halfback, and you've got Louise Burrows in the front row. You've got Michaela Leonard. You've got some really good players there. I think Taylor Stanford was coming off the bench on the weekend.
Yeah, look, it's a nicely balanced squad. Any team would be happy to have a player with the calibre of Taylor Stanford coming off the bench with a little bit of impact, but I think it just goes to show the depth we've created here with, obviously, there's a number of people who are unavailable this year, and look, what we saw on Sunday was just a glimpse of hopefully what we're going to do over the next 7 days.
And a lot of young players too coming through. That's good to see, isn't it? There is a pathway for some of those players playing in school football at the moment.
Yeah, it's brilliant. Look, we always talk about the Brumbies pathway, and we certainly do a good job, especially in the boys sector, and the women's are certainly growing as well. Look, we have 3 out of our 27 players are still at school, so it's certainly proof that the pathway is existing and thriving.
Ella Ryan came off on the weekend. She going to be okay, do you think, for this week?
Yeah, she's okay. Look, she just got blindsided there, a little bit of cork in the leg. She's improving every day, so yeah, she should be fine.
And I guess there is a sense of professionalism within this side. The resources are being put into to make them go that next step, that semi-professional pathway.
Yeah, look, what we've tried to do is obviously develop a program here where the main focus is just for them getting on the field and playing. Look, it's not at the level that we want it to yet, but it's certainly moving in the right direction, and look, there's no cause for complaints on our front.
Short season with the grand final in July.
Yeah, it is. Look, it's different, but look, it's not something that they haven't experienced before. You look back 4 or 5 years ago, they were playing this regularly. So, look, we've had a long preparation, but hopefully we've done our job well. So, look, we just need to continue to review, recover, improve, and, hopefully another 3 positive games in the next 9 days.
Good on you, Lachie. Thanks very much for that.
Perfect. Thanks, Tim.
That's Lachie Creighton down here at Brumbies headquarters with the Brumbies Super W side heading to Coffs Harbour, and they play the President's 15 on Sunday, New South Wales on Wednesday. Back with more in just a moment.
This week's Sports Wrap, proudly brought to you by Snedden Hall and Gallop.
Hello, Tim Gavel here at the Brumbies headquarters. Welcome back to the Sports Report, and just repeating the news, the Brumbies Super W side had a win on the weekend in the opening round of the Super W competition. They now head to Coffs Harbour. Now, the Raiders went down 22-20 to St George Illawarra on the weekend. They've got the bye this weekend because of the state of origin. On Sunday night, Josh Papali'i has been named in the Queensland side in the starting lineup, and Jack Whiten is on the bench for New South Wales. Of course, the Raiders still dealing with that issue, playing that 18th man, Xavier Savage, on the weekend. And obviously there has been a little bit of fallout from that. The Canberra Brave in the ice hockey had a 4-2 win over the Newcastle North Stars, and the Canberra Brave on top of the McCormack Cup. 6 wins from 7 games. They play the Sydney Ice Dogs away next weekend. Great news with mountain bikers Beck and Dan McConnell. They've been named in the Australian team for the Tokyo Olympic Games. And great news with the comeback of Michelle Heyman to local football here in Canberra. She played locally in the Women's Premier League and scored for Gungahlin in their 4-0 win over Wagga Wagga. Jade Brown scoring 2 goals there as well. This is Tim Gavel signing off for the Region Media Group.